In this video, you will get an introduction on how to get started using the Applications and Components catalog. The Applications and Components catalog includes all system components, custom components, and applications available in Tekla Structures. To open the catalog, click the Applications and Components button in the side pane. The components are organized into groups according to their type and material. One way to look for suitable components is to simply browse through the groups. Note that the default groups, which are shown against a gray background, are always available in the catalog. The predefined groups, which are shown against a white background, depend on your environment. The catalog also contains predefined groups for specific usage, such as the engineering group and its subgroups. Another way to find components is to enter a specific search term in the search box. If you know the exact name or number of the component you are looking for, you can type that into the box. You can also enter a more general search term, such as welded, to get a list of all the components that have the word welded. If the list is long, you may want to switch to a different view mode in the catalog. Click the button on the left to show the list view. Click again to switch back to the thumbnail view. Click the button on the right to switch to the compact view. Only small thumbnail images are now shown. This can be useful if you want to save space on the screen. Click again to switch back to the normal view. Here's another way to find components. Use the Show Selected command to list all the components that you have in the current model. Let's start by selecting an area of the model. As you can see, the Show Selected button isn't available. We must remove the search term first. Now click Show Selected. Tekla Structures shows the selected components group, which contains all the components that are currently selected in the model. If you like, you can add more groups to the catalog. For example, you can create a group that contains all of your favorite components so that they are easily available when you need them. To do this, right-click and select New Group. Enter a name and click OK. Let's add End Plate and Tab Plate to the group. Select the components, right-click, and select Add to Group. Note that you can only copy, not move, components. The components still remain in the old group as well. Here is the group with the components we added. Let's say we change our mind and want to remove Tab Plate from the Favorites group. Because we have manually added the component to the group, we can also remove it. Default components and groups can't be removed. For example, you can't remove any default components from the Beam to Beam Connections group. As you can see, there is no such option. But you can hide the default groups and any individual items in those groups. Click Show Hidden Items to find the hidden items again. When you have found the component you want to use, just select it in the catalog and follow the instructions on the status bar to add it to your model. To modify the properties of the component, double-click the component to open the Properties dialog. Make your changes and click Modify.